Hi, I'm here with General Colin Powell, who just gave a great morning keynote speech. General, thank you very much for joining us.
Thank you. My pleasure.
Now, you started off in there talking about the importance of keeping up in the digital age and how you suddenly found yourself with many Facebook friends. Can you tell us that story a little bit?
Well, I was born analog.
Yep.
I mean, but I had to get into the digital world because it is the world of the present and the future, and to keep up with my kids and grandkids. But I've got 4 computers in my home, and I've got 3 smartphones on me, but I was a little reluctant to get involved in all the Twitter world and the Facebook world,
right,
and MySpace and all of that.
Right.
I thought, this is far enough. But my grandson told me that I was already on Facebook without my knowledge. And I said, they can't do that to me. They've done it. Someone's done it. So I had to recapture Facebook, and when I reflected on it, I said, I really don't want to do this. I think I might sue them. He said, Poppy, as he calls me, he said, you already have 15,000 friends. Well, you know, you got to go with
all right,
go
so
with
not
the flow.
So bad.
So I have a Facebook page, and it turns out to be very useful. And it kind of ties into what ASI is doing with ESP and their other technological programs. You've got to live in the world of the young people. You've
got
to live in the world of speed and responsiveness, or you're left behind.
Right, sure. So we're embarking on 2010, and some of your message is about leadership in times of change. What sort of advice do you have for our audience in the way of managing during, you know, maybe just some difficult times?
Your audience is having the same problem that I'm having in my business of speaking, and almost everybody in America is having. The economy's been down. We're all off 10, 20, 30%. This is the time to take a very hard look at what you've been doing to see what maybe you don't have to continue doing,
right,
or you don't want to do again when the economy improves. Get the efficiencies into your system, get rid of inefficiencies, but above all, keep investing in your people.
Mm-hmm.
They're the ones who are going to bring you back. So keep investing in your people, keep investing in research and development to come on with the latest devices and the latest technologies to imprint things or to provide products to your people. This is the time to don't see this as just a problem, but an opportunity.
Right. Now, I know you talk a lot about the importance of communication with your people and being upfront and, you know, effectively communicating, especially in times like these. What sort of advice as far as communication do you have?
In times of anxiety, which borders on fear, people are afraid of losing their jobs, they have mortgages, they have kids in school, leaders have an obligation to speak to their people and to speak to them candidly. Don't sugarcoat, don't tell them fairy stories,
right,
but speak honestly to them. In the military, we say, you can snow anybody except the troops. The troops know when you're, I won't use any improper words to describe
it, right,
but the troops know when you're not being straight with them. And if you're not being straight with your troops, with your employees, with your suppliers, with your providers, with all the people that an ASI family member has to deal with, they'll know it, and they'll lose confidence in you, and they'll start looking for somebody else.
Sure.
And so constant communication with your folks, not just sending out newsletters every month, but getting down on the floor, talking to them, telling them, sharing with them your problem. You know, very often your followers have solutions to your problems that you just haven't shared with your followers.
Right.
So let them know, I have this problem.
Right.
And great companies these days increasingly take advantage of that resource they have in their followers to solve problems.
Right. Certainly some important advice.
Thank you.
Well, thank you for your speech this morning, and thanks for joining us.
Thanks very much.
Thank you. For ASI TV, this is Andy Cohen.